제52회 누구를 닮았어요?
안녕하세요. Welcome to Let's Speak Korean. I'm your host Lisa Kelly and today is our 52nd show. And yesterday we were talking about family and today we're going to go a little bit further and we're going to our main expression for today is 누구를 닮았어요? 누구 is who? Who do you resemble? Who do you look like? Okay, let's get into our program. But first, let me introduce our co-host, my good friend, our great teacher, Stephen. Hi.
Thank you once again, Lisa. 안녕하세요. I'm Stephen Revere. We've got a difficult word for you today. 닮다 has one of those double 받침s, a double final consonant. Don't worry, we're going to work it all out, and Naomi and Nitti are going to help us.
Right.
Introduce yourselves.
안녕하세요, 나오미입니다. Hi, everybody. Today I'm so happy because I got this beautiful T-shirt. Do I look like a
person? Very nice.
Very
yes.
happy. 어때요? 이 티셔츠 어때요?
아니요. 안녕하세요. 안녕하세요, 니키입니다. Sorry, I'm just joking.
Good answer. I know, yeah. But to change the subject. Lisa, I know you look just like your mother. I saw some pictures of you mm-hmm. and your mother. You look just like her. You two are like 붕어빵.
Ah, 붕어빵.
Yes.
And I love 붕어빵.
Do you?
Yeah. 붕어빵 is a, like a delicacy that you can find on the streets here. It's street food. But, oh, and you've got some.
Here. As a matter of fact, yes. Just to help explain 붕어빵, we've uh-huh. prepared a couple of pieces of 붕어빵. You'll notice they look exactly the same, don't they?
Right. Don't touch it too much. I might want to eat one later.
No, I'm sorry. Yeah.
All right. Well, they're pressed in a machine, so they look exactly the same. Okay.
Mm-hmm. And when one thing that Koreans often say when two people look exactly the same, mm-hmm. they will say, "Oh, 붕어빵 같아."
Right.
You guys you look just like each other because, of course. 붕어빵 comes out looking exactly the same
right.
every time. So, fun expression for you all to use with your Korean friends.
Okay. Well, now that we got 붕어빵 down, let's go and check out what we're going to be learning for today.
Let's do it! 리사 씨는 누구를 닮았어요?
어머니를 닮았어요. 눈이 어머니와 똑같아요.
Okay, our expression today, as you heard, is 누구를 닮았어요? And 누구 means who, okay? 누구를 닮았다. Okay, 닮았다 means resemble or look like someone. And Stephen's going to take care of this one, right?
Yes, 닮았다 is the basic form when conjugated into the past tense, right? That's the basic form. 닮았어요 is when in the 어요, 아요 form. 닮았어요. So, notice the pronunciation of this. The 닮다 becomes 닮았어 because that last, oh, look at this. That final M moves up in front of the next vowel, right? That 이응 has no sound because it's just holding the space in front of the vowel. So, 닮았어요, okay? 누구를 닮았어요. And then when you're putting the subject in there, you're asking the question. Notice you have to use the contrastive marker 는 for, in Lisa's case and 은 in my case, 스티븐은, right? You just have to add the 은 at the end. So we've got, actually, why don't you guys ask me?
Yeah, we will. Okay, the first one, we'll ask Stephen who he looks like. Okay, ready, set, go. 스티븐 씨는 누구를 닮았어요?
Mm-hmm. 아, 저는 어머니를 닮았어요.
Okay, let's ask Naomi. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Naomi는 누구를 닮았어요?
저는 언니와 어머니를 닮았어요.
Oh, oh looks like your mother
good.
Or your auntie, right? Okay, let's ask Nitti. 1, 2, 3. Nitti는 누구를 닮았어요?
저는 아버지를 닮았어요.
Okay, very good. All right, now that we've asked who you look like, now we have to get the answer. The answer is, and I guess we've already done it pretty much. Mm-hmm. It's very simple. You just repeat what you've asked. 누구 누구를 닮았어요, right?
Yes, and then that is followed up with 눈이 어머니와 똑같아요. Now notice the fact that 눈이 is the subject, eyes, of course. 어머니와, okay? 와 and 과 is the way that you use and. Now, why did they choose, can you guys tell me by any chance, why did they choose wa here? Why is it wa? That is because it ends in a vowel. Omani ends in a vowel. Now, curiously, normally, if something ends in a vowel, it comes up against ga, something starting with another, with a consonant.
Yeah.
This is the exception in Korean, because when something ends in a vowel, then it comes up against another vowel when you're using wa and gwa, okay? So if it were to end in a consonant, as in omonim, you would say omonim gwa, okay? The high form of omoni is omonim, then you would say omonim gwa. And then that's followed by tokate, which means exactly the same. And you will hear that
like
all the time. Yes, yes. Koreans always have a tendency to use tokate instead of kate. If you just say kate, it means the same. Katayo. Kate. Again, so you should say katayo, but sometimes Seoul pronunciation comes out kate. But don't do that. Don't say kateo. Katayo.
Right. Okay, let's repeat this, okay? Your eyes look exactly the same as your mother, okay? 눈이 어머니와 똑같아요.
눈이 어머니와 똑같아요.
눈이 어머니와 똑같아요.
See, I learned it in Korean and I said it like that too.
똑같아요 is the correct pronunciation. I make the same mistake sometimes.
Okay, so I'll ask
because
you guys.
Koreans all make that mistake. Right,
right? I say it too. I learned my Korean in Seoul too. All right, I'll ask you, where do you resemble your mother or father or whoever, okay? 어디가, where? Okay, 어디가 많이 닮았어요? Where do you resemble whoever? You said your mother or your sister, okay? 어디가 많이 닮았어요?
코가 어머니와 똑같아요.
Good, Ko is nose. Okay, 니티, 어디가 많이 닮았어요?
얼굴이 아버지와 많이 똑같아요.
그래요? 스티븐 씨.
Okay, 많이 똑같아요는 안 돼. It's a lot exactly alike. No, no, no. You can 똑같아요. It's exactly alike.
Or 많이 닮았어요.
많이 닮았어요.
Okay.
That's okay. Yeah.
스티븐 씨, 어디가 많이 닮았어요?
저는 뭐 거의 어머니랑 똑같아요. 그냥 어머니랑 똑같다고 칠 수가 있어요. Yes.
I see. All right. Well, let's go and review what we've learned so far and wrap it up.
Wrap it up
with Lisa
and Steven.
Steven 씨, 누구를 닮았어요?
눈이 브루스 윌리스와 똑같아요.
아니에요. 아, 비슷해요. 눈이 아니고 머리가.
Okay, I heard a very important expression in there. You've got to know this one. 비슷하다, 비슷하다, 비슷하다.
And Bruce Willis. I love Bruce Willis. Because I'm losing a little hair up. And we were going over this in the room as I was getting ready. The hair's getting a little
thinning
thinner
out,
in the front.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, 비슷하다 means similar to. So you can use it in place of resemble, okay? We learned today 닮았다, 그 비슷하다. 닮았다 means only in appearance, right? But 비슷하다 you can use not only for appearance, but other things. For example,
similar.
These two are 비슷하다, you know, they're similar. So not just for what you see, but even taste, okay? Something can taste similar to each other, right? Let's try that. 비슷하다.
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 Notice the pronunciation might seem a little strange. 비슷 ends in a shit, an S
right.
sound, right? But then it comes up against the hit in hada, and then it becomes ta, pisitada.
Right, it's really hard to pronounce. All right, well, those are all our expressions today. Any questions?
No.
No.
All right, kids. All right, please join us back here next time at Let's Speak Korean. We'll have more interesting expressions for you to learn then. Bye-bye.
Arirangtv.com.
Bye-bye.